out of these two, which one is less healthy to eat?
Here's an answer from ChatGPT.
Out of these two, which one is less healthy to eat?
The packet on the right has higher values for total fat, saturated fatty acids, and sodium per serving, so it's less healthy compared to the other one.
What's the power output of this adapter in watts?
The power output of this Samsung adapter is 25 watts.
How did you know that?
Here's an answer from ChatGPT.
What's the power output of this adapter in watts?
The Samsung adapter you've shown has a power output of 25 watts. Is there anything else you'd like to know about it?
How did you know that?
I was able to find the wattage because it's printed on the adapter itself. It's listed as 25W.
Can you tell me the brand of these watches?
The smartwatch on the left, with a round display and teal strap, resembles designs commonly seen in Garmin or Amazfit models, which focus on fitness tracking. The one on the right, with a rectangular display and black strap, has a design similar to the Apple Watch series. However, without visible branding, it's difficult to confirm the exact brands.
Can you tell me the brand of these watches?
The watch on the left is a Noise ColorFit Pro 4 Max, and the one on the right looks like an Apple Watch. Do you have any questions about them?
What's this plant?
The plant appears to be a type of pothos, Epipremnum rheum, recognizable by its heart-shaped green leaves, with occasional lighter streaks. Pothos is a popular, low-maintenance houseplant known for its trailing vines and adaptability to various light conditions.
What's this plant?
That's a lovely golden pothos you've got there. They're known for being easy to care for. Do you have any questions about it?
Solve this equation.
Here's an answer from ChatGPT.
Solve this equation.
All right, I can help you with that. So we have two equations here, right? X plus y equals 6 and x minus y equals 2. To solve for x, we can add the two equations together. That'll give us 2x equals 8, divide both sides by 2, and we get x equals 4.
What's the height of this tripod?
I can't determine the exact height of the tripod from the image alone. To find its height, you can measure it from the floor to the top of the tripod head using a measuring tape. If you have the model name, you can also check the manufacturer's specifications for its maximum and minimum.
Give me an estimate of its height.
Based on the proportions relative to the door handle and glass panels, the tripod appears to be approximately 4.5 to 5 feet tall, about 137 to 152 centimeters in its current extended state. This is an estimate and may vary slightly depending on the actual dimensions of the surroundings.
What's the height of this tripod?
I can't tell the exact height of the tripod from the image, but it looks to be about 5 feet tall. Would you like me to find out the height of a similar tripod for you?
What's the height of the person standing?
I can't accurately determine the person's height just from this photo, as there are no reliable reference objects.
What's the height of the person standing?
Based on the image, the person appears to be of average height, likely somewhere between 5 foot 7 inches and 5 foot 10 inches tall.
What's this creature and does it exist?
The creature in the image is a fantastical, imaginary being, likely created through digital art. It features characteristics such as glowing, colorful wings, antler-like structures, and a mystical appearance, blending traits of dragons, fairies, and mythical creatures. This type of creature does not exist in reality.
What's this creature and does it exist?
That's a beautiful image.
The creature appears to be a fantasy dragon with some insect-like features, especially the antennae. It looks like it's from a game or artwork, so it probably doesn't exist in real life.
What's the day today?
Today is Friday, May 16th, 2025.
And what was the day 2 weeks and 3 days ago?
2 weeks and 3 days ago was a Tuesday, April 29, 2025.
What's the day today?
It's Friday, May 16th, 2025.
What was the day 2 weeks and 3 days ago?
It's Friday, May 30th, 2025.
After putting Gemini and Apple Intelligence through a wide range of real-world tests, including math equations, object identification, reasoning, date calculation, and visual estimation, it's clear that both AIs have strengths. But Gemini emerges as the more consistent and practical performer in this round of testing. Gemini offers a slightly more reliable and practical AI experience in day-to-day scenarios, especially for visual estimation, quick calculations, and contextual understanding. However, Apple Intelligence shows the promising capabilities in object recognition and detailed analysis, even though with occasional dependency on second prompts or exaggerated responses. If you're looking for speed and directness, Gemini is definitely more capable and useful in day-to-day tasks. And that's a wrap for this one. Don't forget to like the video and subscribe to Gizmo Rush for more such tests and reviews. Thanks for watching.